Right, this is part two. I'm using a couple of cuts from Green Velvet, Constant Chaos. It's an LP, and the number of the LP is Motel Motel Lima Papa 003. So that's MMLP 003. All right, so hopefully you'll be able to see. By the way, the mixer is the Formula Sound FF2.2L, and the turntables are the daddies of all turntables, Technics SL1200 Mark II. Okay, so you should be able to see. There's no sort of readout or anything like that. I haven't got any screens, nothing at all. Okay, yeah, you should be able to see that anyway. All right, so what I'll do is I've got the two pitches dead centre, firstly, okay? So there's a lot about this video. Let's just have a listen. Start that one off, get this one in beat. Okay, we can hear those definitely off. Okay, so what I'm going to try and emulate here is the explanation I gave in the last video, the analogy about the gateposts, about how you can get a track in beat but very slightly off, but then have the two working together as a mix for a short amount of time, even though they're not at the same BPM. So, let's first of all get them to the same BPM. So I'm just going to start that one off. Get this one ready. Okay, so that sounds roughly at the same BPM, even though it isn't. All right, so what I'm going to do now, I'm going to show you how you can form a mix with two tracks on vinyl for a short amount of time, even though they are not the same BPM, beats per minute. And I can demonstrate that in two ways. One is, first of all, just doing a short transition, and then secondly, by playing the two together for a greater amount of time to show you that indeed they are not the same BPM. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to, if I can find them, where are they? Down there. I'm going to put my headphones on so I can now get that in beat. No, I'm not going to put my headphones on because I haven't got the right bloody plug. Oh, crap. Oh, there it is. Right, okay. I should organise this before doing it, but there you go. Right, so let's put that. Is that going to fit on there? Right, there we go. Okay, so plug that in there. All right, now, first demonstration is playing them both together so we can hear them go off beat. Second demonstration then is me cueing this one up on the headphones, throwing it in. Now what I'm not going to do is now change the speed of the pitch. I'm going to leave that. So you may see me moving the vinyl forward and back. All I'm doing there is I'm getting it in beat. If I touch the pitch again, it completely defeats the object of this video. Okay, so let's start this off. So the first one now is just letting them play together. Okay, so there's the proof that they are definitely offbeat. Now here is the proof showing that they're offbeat, Here now is the proof of me being able to form a mix of two tracks even though they are offbeat. I hope that makes sense. So, and again, what I'm going to do is use my headphones, and if I feel that this track here is slightly offbeat before I bring it into the mix, I'm going to use the turntable itself to nudge it forward or back. When I know it's in beat at that precise moment, then I'll start to form the mix, bring it in, this one in, take the other one out. So you should be able to hear the two blending together, beat matched, sounding perfectly. But of course, I will only let the mix last for a short amount of time, because if I leave it for too long, then as you heard earlier, the listener will be able to hear it go off beat. Hope that makes sense. Right, so. There. Okay, so there it is. Right, so how does this analogy or how does this demonstration work with the analogy I gave in the first video? It's very simple. The posts are at different positions, the beats were off. The mix I did in the second demonstration was a short mix, and that works with the analogy of the two of us walking along the pathway for a short amount of time before we notice that the two posts are indeed now changing place. They are not exactly opposite each other, all right? Now, I hope that makes sense. It does in my mind. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.